Bakke here, founder of MrOutsource.com and author of the best-selling book called Never Work Again. I am on a road trip in Japan, going to Mount Fuji from the city of Osaka. Just spent quite a lot of time in that region with Kyoto, Osaka, Kobe, Nara, Kyosan, and now just driving for 4 or 5 hours to Mount Fuji. Obviously, Mount Fuji is one of the famous mountains in Japan. It's actually the symbol of Japan. And just got a Toyota Prius here, and I want to talk a little bit about the car. So basically, we just passed Toyota. This is the city of Toyota, and there was thousands and thousands of Toyotas being ready to be shipped all over the world or throughout Japan. And this is a really awesome car. So basically, it's got cruise control. The cruise control adjusts according to the car in front. It tells me if I'm turning, if it tries to keep the car on track as well. And it's just an amazing car. So Toyota Prius, I've never driven one before. Great car, superb, sort of everything's great with it. I've ridden in many with Uber, but never actually driven one myself. So it's a perfect road trip car for Japan. And we've seen so many great things here. A few things about driving in Japan. The speed limits are incredibly low. So be patient. However, you can go a little bit above the speed limit. There's like a gray zone there. So there's nothing, you can't go faster than 80 typically on the motorway. This is a really nice motorway, but I'm only doing about 105 kilometers an hour, which is speeding, but everyone else is doing it too. The road system here is great. We have had some issues with the GPS and navigation, but Google seems to be the best option to use while traveling in Japan. Make sure that you don't use up your pocket Wi-Fi. We had a pocket Wi-Fi for quite a few days until we used all the data. We used all the data because we forgot to turn off automatic updates. And yes, so make sure you have enough data on your pocket Wi-Fi, and you can still use it after you use all your data, but it can be very, very slow. So it can be complicated if you make a wrong turn and it won't update really fast. Also GPS in the car, but it's mostly in Japanese, so it's kind of hard to navigate. Got about 3 hours left here on the drive, so I'll be filming a little bit more in Mount Fuji. We're also staying in a nice onsen there, so we'll be showing you some of that. And after that, we are going to Park Hyatt, which is the next thing on my bucket list. First thing here is driving to Mount Fuji. The second thing is doing a road trip and really seeing Japan from that side of things. So stay tuned. So, beautiful Japan. We're doing 105 on the speedometer, and this road actually has a limit of 80, and that's pretty insane. So I think if there was one thing I would like to say to you, Japan, please increase your traffic limit by at least 20 kilometers, maybe 30. It's just ridiculously slow, and that's all I have to say about that. Beautiful landscape. The motorways seem to always be elevated up. So if you're driving through a city, you're typically not driving on the ground. You're typically driving on some kind of motorway bridge. And they're usually nicely like insulated as well. Maybe a good idea for other cities to like raise up the motorway. So there we are, coming up to Mount Fuji there. Just wanted to make this video in case it's hidden when we get there. Sometimes and mostly it has a white top. Today it doesn't look like it has a white top. It is actually 26 degrees where we are right now, and we have about another 1 hour and 50 minutes to drive. It's a pretty big mountain. I'll tell you more about that later. So finally made it here to Mount Fuji. You can see Mount Fuji here in the back. It's about a 6 hour drive from Osaka. Really good roads, quite far, very expensive as well to drive the roads here. Luckily our Prius was a great car and took good care of us. So basically you can get the gondola up here. You can see the gondola people, get an ice cream, get a beer, There's also a really beautiful lake just over there. It's a lake, and you can go on a cruise there. The hotel is just all over there at the end, where you can actually have a view of Mount Fuji from your room. Mount Fuji is 3,776 meters, and you can summit it. I'm not doing that this time, just simply do not have time to do it. And typically it has snow on top of it, but that's during winter. So this now it's October, so you can't actually see any snowy peaks there today. Quite a large mountain, you see it from far, far away, as you saw from the road trip. So crossing off another thing on the bucket list here, going to Mount Fuji, experiencing this magnificent mountain, and we're gonna enjoy the sunset over it as well later on. So fantastic, really great experience. So here we have it, Fuji View Hotel, it's been amazing. There's a lake behind it, and you have a great view of Mount Fuji just over there. And if you like tennis, they've got tennis courts, and there's also a 9-hole golf course here. So great place to stay for probably a weekend. So amazing times. About to head to Tokyo here to stay at, to cross off another thing on my bucket list, which is stay at the Park Hyatt, same hotel as featured in Lost in Translation. So really, really looking forward to that, and also looking forward to not driving more. So you get a great view here from Fuji View Hotel. You can choose two sides, the front and the back. The front with the view of Mount Fuji was actually fully booked, so we've got the back view here. But still a nice view, and there's a viewing platform on the top we're gonna go check out. And there's an onsen here in the basement, of course, and beautiful grounds to walk around and just relax by the lake during the day. Fuji View Hotel, nice, nice. So Mount Fuji is called a different thing when it's got a white top or when it's got a red top, just like that. Just here at the viewing platform at Mount Fuji Hotel. Beautiful view of the lake behind here. Kind of reminds me of Loch Ness a little bit. And then of course, we have the big guy himself, Mount Fuji right there. So I wanna enjoy a cold beer and I'm gonna enjoy a cold beer. Relax here for a while, and then go down in the onsen and just relax. So that's gonna be amazing. Mount Fuji here, Mount Fuji Hotel, awesome place, highly recommend it. Goodbye, Mount Fuji.
This podcast is brought to you by MrOutsource.com. Outsourcing to the Philippines done for you. Mr. Outsource is a recruitment company.